How much money did I make selling Harry Potter stuff at a car boot sale? Lots of money, yes. Hey there, Potterpuffs. Welcome back to my channel. You can see that I am amongst a lot of stuff today, or maybe you can. There is a lot behind me. Now, this video was highly requested by you guys because I'm doing a car boot sale. So basically, it's Good Friday today, and on Easter Sunday and probably Easter Monday, because of the amount of items I've got behind me, I'm going to be doing a car boot sale, and I'm so excited because I've never done one before. I think I've been to maybe one, but in the UK it's something that a lot of people enjoy doing in the summer months. Last Friday, John said to me, "You're getting to have quite a lot of stuff now, Bloss, and I think both of us need to have a bit of a sort out." And I was just kind of thinking a couple of days before, okay, I've got lots of stuff, I feel a bit cluttered because I live in a two-bedroom flat and I kind of feel like, yeah, I really need to sort some stuff out, but I don't know what to do with it. Generally, what I do is give it all to charity. I didn't really realise just how much stuff I had to give away until I started tidying. It was kind of insane. I wasn't sure whether to do this video, and it definitely wasn't because I didn't want to. It's purely because I was worried that some of you guys might be upset that I'm getting rid of some Harry Potter things, but with the type of channel I do and the type of things I do on Instagram, I can kind of accumulate a lot of stuff and I can't possibly keep it all here. So I've been selective. I have got rid of some things. I am selling these things, just to let you know, for incredibly cheap prices. By the time you see this video, the car boot sale will obviously be done, but what I'm trying to make out here is that I'm not selling these things for rip-off prices like some people do on eBay. These people who buy these items are going to be really, really happy because they're things like 50p a pound, and I know I could make more and sell it online, but that isn't the point. I would like to be able to give these things for very cheap prices to people who probably can't afford to pay the prices of eBay or when you buy things new online. I'm going to show you some of the items that I'm selling, what I've been doing at home, because this week I've literally been stickering up items and doing lots of things around the house, which I've really enjoyed actually. And then we've got lots of things to do to get it all sorted in the car and ready for Sunday. We are gonna spend the money on home improvements because we need to put a lick of paint on some walls. Our bathrooms desperately need doing, and there's lots of things around the house which, in all fairness, we could have saved our money for, but we haven't because there's other things we'd rather buy. So I'm going to show you some of the items that I'm selling. First of all, we have some CDs right here, massive pile. Who buys CDs now? This is the kind of issue I've been coming up against. Everything's digital now, so things like DVDs, CDs, places like CEX, which is a shop for secondhand like DVDs in the UK and games, they sell them for like 10p anyway, or they buy them off you for 10p and maybe sell them for 50, so they're worth little to nothing. Unless you've got a really rare DVD, you're really not going to make much. So all my CDs I've got here, 20p, 10p. There's one that's £2 because it's relatively new, 10p. We have cookery books. Now, cookery books are never something that I use. I usually Google recipes. I did used to use my slow cooker, but it's not something I do anymore. Me and John share out the cooking each day, so again, not really necessary. Loads of DVDs. I've got lots of books, lots of toys. You know me and cuddly toys, I have so many. We have a Dynamo magic kit, which I got when I went to see him live, but I've realised that actually doing magic is incredibly hard, so I kind of thought I'd sell that. But I know what you guys want to see. You want to see what Harry Potter merch I'm selling, and I'm going to show you that right now. Excuse the mess of this video, because my house is messy because of what I'm doing here. Okay, so Harry Potter merch. As you can see, a lot of it is little bits and pieces that I might have picked up from Primark and things like that. Things I've had quite a long time where I have duplicates of. For instance, Voldemort. I absolutely love. I just have two of them, so that's why he's going. I have too many cushions, as you know, so I had to kind of get rid of a few of my Harry Potter cushions, like this one. An eye mask, I mean, that's 30p. Money tin, 50p. I have a big selection of books. Pops are super tricky. I love them, but as I said to you guys before, I don't want to collect too many. So we're selling Percival Graves, Safina, Newt, and my spare Tom Riddle. We have some bags right here. We have another clutch bag. A piece of jewellery. I went through it and chose all my favourite things. We are selling some mugs because, as you know, the mug struggle is real, and I thought that I would keep my favourites and make some room in my kitchen. I did not want this set that John got me last year. I was like, okay, it was free for two, thank you. And I did appreciate it,
but it's a spider, and I was like, can I please sell that now? I am also selling some Rarebit 3D puzzles, which I bought a couple of years ago. I've kept my favourite though, which is the burrow. The thing you're probably going to be really interested in is this box. Now this is a box of loads of little items. All of these items I'm going to sell for probably either 10p or 20p each. So it's like a lucky dip. Whatever you find in there, you can buy for like 10p, maybe less. It depends on the size of the item. So if someone looks at something and goes, can I have that for five? I'll probably say, yeah, just depends what it is. So I'm gonna make a sign for the box that just says all items like 10p, something like that. One other thing to address today is, yes, my hair turned green. You might not be able to see it on camera, but the silver turned green. So I'm working to fix that at the moment. So if you look at it and think, oh, has her hair changed like for the third time recently? I'm pretty much Tonks, okay? So I've been stickering up. This is what I've been doing. I've literally been cutting up, John has been cutting up these labels for me, and I've just been deciding off the top of my head how much I want to sell things for. It is time for bed because it's about 10 o'clock now. Usually I wouldn't go to bed that early. And by the way, now it is the day before the car boot. We've put everything in the car and we've just been watching for the past hour and a half YouTube videos of people doing car boot sales. And it's quite exciting because they look very busy. People seem to be making around £200. And I kind of really hope that that's what we're going to make. I mean, the Harry Potter stuff, I do think is going to sell really well. A few of you Potter Puffs have kind of messaged me and said you're coming, which is great. And I just kind of think it's full of good stuff, our stalls. So I don't feel it's like rubbish, which I'm really, really excited about because I do think this is going to be great. So tomorrow I have to get up, me and John, at 6 o'clock in the morning. We have to leave the house, which is insane for him because he never gets up that early unless it's a holiday. So he's going to hate his life for a while. One thing I find quite difficult of things like this, I've never really done this, is number one, I'm not good at maths, so counting out people's change is going to be a struggle. And number two is the fact it's going to be very busy, and I'm fine with busyness. I'm fine with talking to people, as you know from doing YouTube, but people come and look in your car and come over to your stall often before you've set it up. Now, I like to be a bit of a perfectionist and set things up nicely, so I don't really want people to disrupt my stall before I've done it, which is really silly because if they're buying stuff, then that's fine. So I'll see you guys tomorrow up bright and early, ready to go. It's only a 5-minute drive from our house, so you'll see us at the car boot probably next. I have never done this before and it's already extremely busy. You would not think that it is literally like 6:30 in the morning. There's people everywhere, there's stuff everywhere. It's insane. I need to get unloaded, but this is really, really cool. The boot is completely chock-a-block, so we're going to get everything out right now. It is mental. We didn't even finish setting up our stuff and everyone's already buying stuff, so I haven't really had any time to film so far. But the Harry Potter stuff's already selling really, really quickly. We've sold pops, we've sold games, loads of stuff, all the little bits. I didn't anticipate me not even setting up before this happened, but yeah, look at the stall, it's crazy.
Another version of the night bus. Hagrid's hut's coming back.
Is it? Yeah. Oh, that's exciting.
So my daughter has to know. I've already seen the figure.
Have you seen that? I've got a book on Lego.
I've already got
that. Oh, she, I'm just, you're one step ahead of me.
Lego and
and Harry Potter is her life.
Oh, I love it. I love the Quidditch set. I got that at home.
Does that do anything?
Or? No, it's decorative.
No, it's decorative.
Yeah. There's a lot of those things.
On your mask, what is that gold thing? It's not the snitch, is it?
Oh, that's a dragon egg.
Oh, dragon egg.
That was a good... Let me have that.
Oh, yeah, please.
30, 30, 30, 30,
50,
£1. Have a good day.
Thank you, you too.
Good morning.
Good.
Nice day for a car boot
sale. Lovely, yeah, it's beautiful. You're facing the sun all the time, right?
I know.
Yeah, that's it, sunny in your eyes.
I was in the sun yesterday as well. It was a bit red last night.
Yeah? Yeah, very well. The Harry Potter side of things has been severely raided, actually. My 30p box has not got much left in it. We've sold some of the clothes. So I think we've made quite a bit so far, actually.
I'll go for £5.
For both.
When she opens it,
she opens it
like that.
Oh wow, that's very
she
good.
She doesn't break the spire. She won't use that to go like that.
No. Well, that's very, very good. She's a
fantastic. And I think she's read every single one 3 times. There is not a question about Harry Potter that you cannot ask her.
Really?
Wow.
My nephew's just bought himself one of these in
For what, sorry?
For a wand.
Did he? Yeah, oh, well,
and
that's...
And it's about as heavy as that.
Is it? Well, yeah. They're not official, but yeah, they are good substitutes, to be honest. Yeah, £28
as well. I know. Got, it was his birthday money, so it was up to him, but I just thought,
yeah, some of the more ice and small
ones
do come with a bit of a bang.
It's just a Harry Potter nerd.
Start wishing at that sort of price, it will start performing a bit of magic.
That's what his mother said. £1.50, £1.50, £2.
Perfect, nice and easy. Have a lovely day, thank you. Come on, Steve and Gerard, you need to sell, everyone loves football.
Years gone by, I reckon books would have flown off, but I think people are less attracted to them now.
CDs, nobody cares about, do they?
But then if my mum was here, like, she'd be loving the books.
She would be loving the books.
Is it the whole set?
It is, apart from the very last Deathly Hallows.
You got part one, have you?
Part one, yeah, and that's the Blu-ray, that one.
One in the paper.
Yeah, all of them? It's created us some.
Is that a Blu-ray, yeah?
Yeah, that one's a Blu-ray.
Yeah, we've got a Blu-ray.
Okay, we'll go with these ones then. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Have you seen the films before?
Yes.
Ah, lovely.
Question is, is there all in it?
Yes, they are, just the way they are.
Yeah. We bought one off Amazon.
Thank you, mate.
Oh, well, that's so good.
Hello.
This is Lauren, one of my Potter Puffs. It's been really nice to meet you.
Oh, thank
you. She's bought 2 pops off me. It's very exciting.
I'm literally, like, so excited.
So, you'll be on the video soon. It'll be really weird to see you on TV.
I know, it'll be really
weird. On TV, on YouTube. But yeah, it's been lovely meeting you, Lauren.
Oh, thank you.
So this has been crazy, guys. Basically, I just thought I was just in the way then.
We've sold loads. Most of the Harry Potter stuff's gone now. It's been very busy. It's gone through like quiet periods, busy periods, but overall it's been great and people have been really excited about my stuff. I met a fan, as you just saw. Lauren was lovely and she bought a couple of things. And then other than that, I've just had a little wander around. I'm trying not to buy things because the whole point of this is to make money so that I can buy stuff to decorate my house. So that's what I've been doing. I'm trying to not get an ice cream and a burger now because the last few days I've had like loads of barbecues, so I don't really think me now having an ice cream and burger is a good idea. The weather's hotted up now. I definitely didn't need my jumper, but it was cold this morning when we started. I don't know how much money we've made, basically. Look in my bag. So I just got like loads of money in my bag. I have no idea. Can you jiggle it? It's very, very full. But yeah, I have no idea how much money we've made. We've had to drop the prices on a few things, but to be honest, I just want to get rid of it. So any money we make is going to be really good money. This is Kim! She's come to find me. Oh, I don't know if you came to find
yes,
me.
Yes, I did.
But this is the second Potter Puff I've seen today, which is very exciting.
I think the first one was my cousin, actually.
Ah, is so your Lauren? Cousin's with Lauren. Yeah, right, yeah. Perfect. And they both watch my videos. How exciting! This is the stage we're at with the car boot. As you can see, this used to be a Harry Potter table, but now it's not really a Harry Potter table anymore. There's not so many Harry Potter bargains. We've got a few things left. It's really not that many. We've got a few things on the ground. It's mainly the clothes that we're trying to get rid of now. And John's eating his fruit.
Yeah, he's here, that's all right.
Yeah, perfect.
£2
for both.
Thank you.
Hello.
Bye.
The stall is really, really bare now. Spot the Harry Potter items. You can barely even see any. It's just the odd things now we're trying to get rid of. I'm happy a lot of the clothes is going, but we've put the price down on those to just £1 now. But most of the Harry Potter t-shirts have sold. Do you remember this earlier? This was a lot busier, so we have done a really good job. So John, how much money do you think we've made so far?
It's
difficult, isn't it? We've been taking a lot of money. I've given back a couple of wrong changes.
Probably 150.
150. See, that
which
seems
I think
to be
on the low side because we have had a good day, but
it's better to aim like not too high. I'm going to say 100.
I'll be pleasantly surprised. Yeah.
Yeah. Hopefully 180. I'm going to go for. So the prices have gone down. This is all that's left. And it's 50p or less, so you can get some real bargains now, but we just want it gone because we're going to pack up in about 20 minutes. We've sold most of it and we'll just try and get rid of any more stuff that we possibly can now. So it's hard to show you, this bag is incredibly heavy. There are lots of notes. We're hoping that maybe, I'm hoping it's nearly 200, but I don't know. I haven't really been taking notice of what money people have been giving me. There's a lot of coins at the bottom as well. This is such a good way to clear out your stuff, make some money, make a good video. It's been a very, very successful day. Right, Potter Puffs. Well, I've caught the sun, as you can see. I proper caught the sun, actually. I got £150 changed, and I didn't actually need it, but I didn't want to be left with not having change for people. Most people have the correct money. That's all the money that I believe we've made, with some hand gel just rattling around in there. This is the change that I got out, which I didn't actually use. So first of all, I'm going to count out £150, which I'm not going to show you because that'll be incredibly boring. And then I will count out what I've actually made. Leave your predictions in the comments down below and let me know what you think I've made. I said earlier, and John said he thinks 150, I think 180. Let's see what this Easter Sunday has brought us. This is exciting. We have lots of notes. I've counted out £150, so that's what I started with. We have all this to count now, and lots of money. Yes. So we ended up surpassing our target by a lot, and we come in at £213.70. A lot of money was made, and that was all out of things that I was getting rid of. So it's well worth doing a car boot sale. If you're kind of umming and ahhing about doing one, I would definitely suggest giving it a go, because it's only things you'll probably give away anyway or just put in the bin potentially. So why not try and sell them for a little bit of money? Most of the items I was selling for very small amounts, but it all mounted up towards the end. And that's what's happened. So now we've got that money to put towards home improvements and things like that. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you thought of it and enjoy the rest of your Easter Potter Puffs. Bye.